I would control this disease. This disease would not control me, and it didn't stop me from doing anything.
I was diagnosed with type 1 diabetes at the age of 14, and that was in 1962.
I was diagnosed around my 16th birthday.
I was diagnosed at 8 in 1959.
I was 10 and a half years old, and I remember the date, December 10th, 1964. Back in the day when I was first diagnosed, I really didn't want to tell anybody because there was that stigma about it, and also you were told in subtle terms, you know what, you might not live as long as someone else. So it's for someone who was 11 years old when I was diagnosed, that's a pretty sobering, pretty heavy load to carry.
Living with type 1 diabetes is very demanding. You really do have to plan a lot. You have to measure your, not only your blood glucose, but you have to measure everything. You know, your activity level, what you eat, where you're gonna be, what emergencies may arise, and that's a lot for an individual to handle anyway.
Having diabetes made me a very determined person. I was not going to be a statistic, I was not going to be an amputee, I was not going to be blind, I was not going to be on dialysis, and I will be the first to say that I am just blessed to so far not be one of those things.
I had to fight hard because I wanted to be active, and it's like, don't tell me I can't do anything. So I fought hard to be a cheerleader for football and basketball for 4 years. I ran track. I was in the ski club. I worked in many of the gym shows. And I won the Presidential Physical Fitness Award for 4 years in high school. And it's like, don't tell me I can't do it.
I was able to study abroad for a year. I have traveled all 7 continents. I have ran my own company for 25 years. Anything and everything I've wanted to do, I've done it.
The technology, of course, now, you know, is amazing.
I'm already stunned by what they have learned in recent years with these studies that are going on. Yeah, so it's very exciting to be with so many other insulin-dependent diabetics 50 years or more.
I'm no longer using syringes, reusable syringes, or multiple daily injections. I'm on an insulin pump, and that to me was a real advance.
It's just been such a different lifestyle, but I've gone through all of it. It's like you start at the bottom and work your way up. Now I wear a pump, a glucose monitor, and things are good. Life is good.
Yes, it has impacted my life for sure, every day.
It ain't fun, but it is possible.
You're gonna fall down, you're gonna have a low blood sugar, you're gonna have a high blood sugar. The day that you think you've had it all figured out is the day that you know, I can't figure it out.
Deal with the cards you're dealt. If you have a high blood sugar or you have a bad day, tomorrow's another day. Get up and do better.
You go on with life. That's the important thing, you live.
And don't be afraid. You know, so many people are afraid of diabetes. I mean, I get up every morning and I'm just happy to be here. I'm not going to let fear of what might happen, you know, cause me not to enjoy my life. I'm certainly not going to do that.
You have to be honest with yourself. And in case of type 1 diabetes, if you're not, the only person who pays is you.
You can do anything you want to. Do not let diabetes define you.
Don't be hard on yourself. It may not always be the end of the world.
I'm not ready to give this life up by any means yet.
Life is about balance. Your blood sugar is about balance. You just have to go with the flow. But you can deal with this disease.
Run into someone and they'll say, you know, well, why are you here? My son over there is 5 years old and he was just diagnosed 2 years ago or whatever. And I'll say, well, I've had it 55 years, and they just cover me with hugs and kisses and really, really, it's possible. You really can do it. You really can live that long with it.
I mean, there was a whole body of knowledge waiting to be adopted that really Joslyn set the standard for.
I had a fantastic relationship with them. I mean, I don't ever remember being told that I couldn't do anything.
Joslyn has been very supportive. I think the medalist program is fantastic because it inspires people to congratulate them on doing the best job they can do.
On my bucket list right now is to get that 75-year medal. And I suspect that the only thing that's going to stand in the way of me now at 50 years getting the 75-year medal is that it probably is going to be cured before I reach the 75-year state. So I'll be back for the celebration of how we ended diabetes.
Today, the sky's the limit.